This video is brought to you by Raycon. The thing about Malcolm and Marie is it's an art film. I think you would have to have an appreciation for filmmaking, cinematography, and screenwriting to truly appreciate it. I found it captivating, but more so because I was analyzing it. But I also have a film degree. In a very unexpected turn of events, Malcolm and Marie feels like it's the most controversial flick since Joker. I guess if I were to briefly explain why, it must have something to do with both of them being super good at imitating other great filmmakers while failing to say anything of any substance themselves. But Joker is at least entertaining, no? Malcolm and Marie is this new Netflix film directed by Sam Levinson, director of Assassination Nation and the creator of Euphoria. You may have heard of it. And it stars Zendaya and John David Washington, two sweethearts that you can't help but love. It's about a couple who have a big ol' fight, and it was filmed in the midst of the pandemic with a very small crew. I think that's all that needs to be said. I guess I should start by saying I don't think Malcolm and Marie is the worst thing in the world. It has some really beautiful cinematography for one, even if... You know what, I'll expand on that in a second. And the performances from Zendaya and John David Washington are both outstanding. The music throughout is super smooth and inviting. Who doesn't like jazz? And that's... Well, I think that's all the good I have to say about it. Malcolm and Marie reads mostly like a play rather than a film, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. You got some really good performances out of it because of that, but I also think there's a huge gap between the viewer and the characters. Like, for how much emotion is being thrown at the wall throughout the entire flick, for how many dramatic, loud, and intense monologues are delivered, I felt nothing. And that's because Malcolm and Marie is honestly less like a play, and more like Sam Levinson whining for 100 minutes. It could not be more obvious, but for anyone out of the loop, Levinson got a really bad review from an LA Times writer about his film Assassination Nation a few years ago, and there's a pretty heavy rant right off the bat and throughout the film where Malcolm trashes an LA Times writer who turns out to give him a glowing review for his film. This is in the movie, this isn't in real life. But Malcolm's not upset at, like, the glowing review. He's upset at how the critic talked about his movie and that they made it political by making it about race, which then prompts Malcolm to get into this rant about what role race has in Hollywood and whether or not the fact that him being a black filmmaker has any effect on how his work is read. And then you gotta keep in mind that the writer from the LA Times is a white woman, which of course prompts a separate, somewhat related rant on white feminism and what role white women have in this conversation. This is all being acted out and performed by a person of color, and this is the guy writing all of it. And I don't think these are conversations that shouldn't be had, I just, to be honest, don't care what this guy has to say about them. And it'd be one thing for me to say that before watching the movie, but I did watch it, and I that's why I'm saying it. The film proves that point, in that most of what Malcolm is ranting about holds no significance towards larger conversations that would feel significant. It's just him talking about himself. Which, mind you, could not be more obviously based off of Levinson, not an actual black filmmaker from what we know of. And with all that said, I don't think it's tough to deduce from that Sam Levinson is, let's admit it, a little insecure about his work and how people view it. Not just speaking for him based on how Malcolm reacts, but if you're gonna make a film this petty, all about critics, it's like, come on, man. And he tries to cover this insecurity with some half-baked stance on race in Hollywood told through the perspective of a black filmmaker. And I'm white, who am I to say if this stance is at all convincing or authentic, but I do know it feels wildly insignificant, not only from where it comes from, but how it's presented. Even if you disagree with all of what I just said and think it does offer some sort of insight, first of all, I'd love to hear what that insight is, and second, I still think it's just kind of a mess of a movie. Because he doesn't just cover his pettiness with these race-related topics. The main plot of this film is actually the abusive relationship between these two people, Malcolm and Marie, which is missing so many pieces and so much room to breathe for it to at all translate to the viewer. Once again, I'm sure I'm alone here, and maybe a lot of people did get something out of these two yelling at each other for an hour. But I stand by what I said. I really don't think it's that complicated why I don't feel invested. I don't feel invested because these don't feel like people. They feel like lines on a page, a collection of monologues that only exist in this movie. I'm never convinced that these two people existed before or after the film. What exists is one guy, and that's Sam Levinson. Now, Marriage Story was my favorite movie of 2019, and I only bring it up because I can see a lot of you immediately using that against me and most of what I'm saying. Probably because Noah Baumbach does a very similar thing, where Charlie is almost hilariously similar to Baumbach from the way he looks to the way his career appears. Baumbach has said in some interviews that it's loosely based off of his own divorce, and at times it definitely reads a little silly with everyone constantly coming up to Charlie and calling him an artistic genius, like, not too subtle there. But I think Bombeck gets away with it because Charlie is a movie character, not a journal in a form of a human. Marriage Story works because the events and emotions within the film are driven not from Charlie's inner rage, but from how that rage is reflected upon when faced with the different characters and situations he finds himself in. Marriage Story wouldn't be what it is without the lawyers, without his son, without the locations, without this strange Scarlett Johansson dancing shot. It's full of different angles that, by the time the film ends, gives you a much fuller picture at what these two characters mean and represent. It's why I hate when people only associate this film with the screaming scene, because that's not what Marriage Story is. It's not just two people screaming at each other. That's a culmination of everything the film was building towards. Malcolm and Marie, now that's two people screaming at each other. Marie is actually a pretty interesting character who I wish I could have seen more from, but we never really get to see more than one side of her. It's like we're on one very narrow trail, and there are other trails we can break off to and explore, but the film chooses to just focus on this one, and the trail gets a little steeper with it, but it never really evolves into anything. All of this is soaked in an aesthetic so aggressive but so empty that it just comes off kind of pretentious. This is frustrating because I do actually like Sam Levinson's directing in Euphoria. It feels very in tune with the characters in the show, whereas this just feels quote-unquote artsy for the sake of being so. The jazz is nice, but it adds nothing. The cinematography is nice, but feels like something you'd find on Tumblr. The fact that it's in black and white feels completely pointless. I genuinely don't know what that was supposed to add other than tricking the viewer into thinking this was some form of high art that it clearly isn't, which, for the record, I don't have a problem with. If something looks nice, it just looks nice, and most of this does. It's the fact that there's no purpose or connection at all between the look and the writing to feel as though any of these choices push the story forward. They do nothing to enhance the mood that this clearly is being driven on. They were all for an aesthetic that doesn't make any sense. It looks like a commercial. Like, again, I don't think Malcolm and Marie is the worst thing ever. I think some critics are overreacting, and I think some people that love it are, they need to find another movie. I guess I still recommend checking it out if you were interested in doing so. Zendaya and John David Washington, like I said, are phenomenal, but it's a mess. It is a total hot mess. When trying to figure out what the point of the film was, I didn't think about the relationship or the race stuff or even the role critics have in art. All very interesting topics. No, I thought this is a movie for Sam Levinson to get some steam out, and he used a black filmmaker as a way of doing so. I don't know why he did this. I don't know who this movie is for. I don't know why it was made. But similar to Sam Levinson, I also made this video to let off some steam and voice my shitty opinions on something, so who am I to call myself anything better? But alright, that's the Malcolm and Marie video. Go watch it and form your own opinion, and before you head out, I want to thank today's sponsor, Raycon. Raycon is disrupting the electronics industry by designing premium wireless audio at half the price, without compromise. From the way they design their products to the way they price them, Raycon prioritizes the customer experience from start to finish. They offer their wireless earbuds in a range of fun colors and patterns with a variety of fit options and no dangling wires or stems. The company was founded by Ray J, and celebrities like Snoop Dogg are obsessed with these guys. And they have a 45-day free return policy. They give you 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a comfortable fit to make it the best experience possible. They're the perfect earbuds for any occasion, whether I'm recording a podcast, doing yoga, or even just hanging out and listening to music. Click the link in the description or go to buyraycon.com/Karsten to get 15% off your Raycon purchase.